Like most good stories, this one starts in a tavern, as the party finds out about an ancient magical sword that was stolen from the local temple. The main suspect was a robed man with magical talent. With this information, the party agrees to retrieve it and stop whatever plans he hopes to achieve. Locating the study of the main suspect, a wizard, the party must seek out any clues regarding the stolen sword. As they enter the study, they find a packed library filled with books and scrolls. Undead servants shamble about the study, patrolling for any intruders. The party could sneak and avoid the undead or simply fight their way through the guards. With luck, they find a map on his desk with the possible location of a portal and a plan to bring forth an ancient dragon into this plane. A non-perceptive party may not be aware, however, that the wizard had left another countermeasure, in the form of an owl familiar, spying on their every move. The party moves towards the portal site, however the owl has relayed information back to its master. To help buy him some time, the wizard has acquired the skills of a band of orcs who have set up camp in the valley. With the promise of power, and more importantly gold, they guard the entrance to the cave. Using his knowledge, the wizard ordered traps placed to hinder the party's progress. Pushing through, the party finds the portal room, but they appear to be too late as the dragon steps through. With his powers not fully restored, the party must act now if they hope to save the city. With a hard-fought battle, the party defeats the wizard and the dragon, closing the portal by retrieving the sword just in time before its unstable magic destroys the cavern. With the wizard defeated, the party has one more job to do: help themselves to his hoard of treasure, payment for a job well done.